In today's video, I'll show you how to easily make complex selections using Affinity Photo. Let's start by using the Flood Select tool to select the sky in this image. After clicking the magic wand icon in the tools palette, I just need to click on an area of the sky. When I do this, you can see the marching ants appear around what Affinity Photo has selected. You may be able to see this better if I turn on the Quick Mask view by clicking the icon in the toolbar. Now you can see a red mask over the area of the image that isn't selected. If I zoom in, you can see the Flood Select tool has selected the sky right up to the fine branches of the tree. But the problem with this is that it hasn't selected the sky you can see between the tree branches. Let's switch back to the view with the marching ants and I'll show you a couple of ways to fix this. In the toolbar, you'll see that there's a mode section with four icons. These icons change the behaviour of the selection tool, allowing you to modify any current selection. The default option is to create a new selection. This creates an entirely new selection, replacing any existing selection you might have made. If I click on an area of sky showing between the tree branches, it then selects that and removes the selection from the larger area of the sky. What we really need to do in this situation though is to use the Add mode so we can add new areas to an existing selection. Whilst the Add mode is useful, and I can use it to select all the additional areas between the branches, that isn't very practical. Fortunately, there's a much easier and faster way. The reason the Flood Select tool didn't include the areas of the sky between the branches was because they were surrounded and not considered part of the sky. What controls this behaviour is the contiguous option in the toolbar. When using the contiguous option, an area must be next to another area that's included in the selection for that area to be included. Because the sky between the branches is cut off from the rest of the sky, it's ignored. Here's what happens when I turn off the contiguous option and click the sky again. This time, all the pixels that match the colour sampled in the sky are included in the selection. This is a much better selection, but there are still some problems. We now have other areas of the image that are included in the selection, but which aren't part of the sky. Let's look at a couple of tools we can use to fix this, and which you can use in all sorts of circumstances. I'll start with the Freehand Selection tool, which allows me to draw around areas with the mouse to select them. This has three type settings that change how you use the tool. The one to use in this example is the Freehand option, because it allows me to quickly draw around areas to select them. When I zoom into the image, you can see the lake is currently included in the selection. To remove it, I can use the Subtract mode with the Freehand Selection. Now, I can draw roughly around the lake, and when I release the mouse, it's removed from the selection. This is easy and fast to do, and I don't even need to close the area I'm drawing around. As soon as I release my mouse button, Affinity completes the selection and removes it. I can also use this tool to easily clean up other problem areas. Look more closely at the horizon. You can see the selection is spilling onto the hills in the distance because they aren't well defined against the sky. It's very easy to use the Freehand Selection tool to draw along the mountains to remove them. Having done that, let's zoom out to see the entire image, and you might notice other areas of the foreground that are included in the selection. I could use the Freehand Selection tool to remove these as well, but I can also use the Rectangular Marquee tool. Using this with the Subtract mode, I can draw around the entire lower part of the image to remove it from the selection. Let's do a check with the Quick Mask, and you can see that it's pretty much a perfect selection. I'll save the selection in case I want to use it again. You can do this in the Select menu by choosing Save Selection as a spare channel. This saves the selection you've made as part of the image so that it's easy to find when you want to use it again. If I go to the Channel Studio panel, you can see the new spare channel that's been saved. By right-clicking on the channel, I can rename it to Sky Selection so that it's easily recognised. After that, I can clear my selection. Now, the mistake lots of people make when using Affinity Photo is to try to create a selection using a single tool. This is probably because the tools seem so good at what they do, but it hardly ever works unless it's a very simple selection. Instead, you need to combine the different tools as we've done in this example. Also, be sure to use the Add and Subtract modes, because creating a complex selection with one click is almost impossible. Break down the selection you want to make into sections or stages. Another common mistake is trying to use the wrong selection tool for the job. Look at what happens when I try to select the sky with the Selection Brush tool. It just can't handle the fine branches or the gaps between the trees. The selection brush tool is better for making large selections where there's a contiguous area to select and a clear and smooth edge. A better option in situations like this is to use the flood select tool, where you can turn off the contiguous option to create the bulk of the selection with a single click. We can then refine that selection with the freehand selection tool. This excels at allowing you to quickly draw rough selections around objects. There's also the rectangular marquee tool, which is great for selecting rectangular shaped areas. Let's go back to the original selection we saved in the channel studio panel. When I right click on the save channel, I can choose the load to pixel selection option. I'll then turn on the quick mask so you can see the unselected areas in red. Zooming in, Affinity Photo has made an excellent job of selecting even the finest details. But if it hadn't, we can use the refine button to easily fix problem areas. If you want to know how to use the refine tools, watch this video next. And if you enjoyed this video, let me know in the YouTube comments, and please share it with other Affinity Photo users.